Welcome to Unfiltered. I'm SE Cupp. Well, who had Trump makes fun of seniors on their 2020 bingo card? It's hard to imagine because it's hard to fathom why any politician running for any elected office would ever make fun of seniors, aka the largest voting bloc in America. And yet, take a look at this new Trump tweet just 3 weeks before the election. Biden for president. He's photoshopped there in a wheelchair, surrounded by senior citizens, presumably at an old folks' home. Now, for a guy who's a whopping 3 years younger than Biden, it's a bold strategy, Cotton. It now seems like the only voting bloc Trump hasn't mocked is white supremacists, the chosen ones. Now, I don't know much, but this, making fun of seniors, voters over the age of 65, and a quarter of the electorate, the highest share since 1970, seems like bad politics. Now, the tweet was roundly rebuked even by some Trump supporters who wondered what the heck the president was thinking. Which begs the question, is he? Because in recent weeks, Trump has not only mocked his biggest block of voters, he's, well, let's tick him off, contracted COVID and held super spreader public maskless events, including one at the White House where the virus has infected more than 24 staffers and family members. He's announced falsely that we have a cure for COVID and told Americans not to be afraid of the virus, which has killed more than 215,000 people in this country. He's proposed kissing voters at his next rally while carrying a deadly infectious disease. He blamed Gold Star families, the families of fallen U.S. troops, for giving him the virus in the first place. He blew up talks on a COVID relief package that would help millions of Americans suffering from the economic impact of the pandemic, and then changed his mind. He abandoned another presidential debate, which, double digits behind Biden, only he needs. Biden took the obvious win and decided to hold his own town hall on ABC. Trump then rushed to do the same over on NBC. Competing town halls, great idea. He went after the governor of Michigan, a totally unimportant state, after it was revealed she was the target of a terror plot to kidnap her. He's wondered out loud why Hillary Clinton, Joe Biden, and Barack Obama aren't in jail, and attacked LeBron James for being a very nasty spokesman for the Democratic Party. He's gone on wild, roidy Twitter sprees, attacking his own appointed medical experts and retweeting bizarre conspiracy theories, like the one where Osama bin Laden is still alive and Joe Biden and Barack Obama may have had SEAL Team 6 killed. Okay. Now, these are not the actions of a man who feels like he's about to win an election. In fact, it seems like Trump may be resigned to losing the popular vote and maybe holding out hope for another split result where he wins the Electoral College. Current polling shows that's a long shot, but the ghosts of 2016 would like to have a word. It feels as if Trump is self-destructing in the 11th hour. And even more shockingly, it appears as if Republicans are willing to go down with the ship. Back to great horse, guys. Now, I know it seems like the election is right around the corner. It's just under 3 weeks away. But 3 weeks is still an awful long time in politics, especially in the erratic era of Trump. I shudder to think what he'll do next. Okay, that's it for me. Be sure to catch my new CNN digital series, What Comes Next, on CNN.com. I'll see you next week.